Hi students, in this geography session we'll be discussing in detail about ocean currents. In the previous classes we discussed about hydrosphere, that means importance of oceans, then tides and other kind of movements of ocean water, etc. We discussed in details. And today's class will be discussing about ocean currents. This video will be an introductory part of the ocean currents. I'll be discussing the all ocean currents with the help of diagrams and the videos. So in order to know about ocean current, you should have an idea about world map. You should know about the continents and which are the important oceans. All these you should have an idea. Then only you will come to know that which are the important ocean currents which are flowing in all these important oceans, like which are the ocean currents in the Pacific Ocean, which are the ocean currents in the Atlantic Ocean and Indian Ocean. All these we have to study in detail. So ocean currents are there are mainly two type of ocean currents are there: warm ocean current and cold ocean current. The warm ocean current always flow from the equatorial region to the polar region, and cold ocean current always flow from the polar region to the equatorial region. So these are the mainly two type of ocean current: warm ocean current and cold ocean current. Then there are number of warm ocean currents in Pacific Ocean and also in the Atlantic Ocean and Indian Ocean. We will go through all these important warm ocean current, and there are also number of cold ocean current in Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. So we have to go through all these important warm ocean current and cold ocean current. Then this we have to only discuss with the help of a world map and also with the help of diagram and video. This matter can be clear. Okay, then we have to also discuss about the causes of ocean currents. This is how these ocean currents are originating in these oceans. There are several factors which causes the origin of ocean currents from the all these oceans. One of the important factor is that variation in temperature. Temperature is an important factor. Then salinity. Salinity means salt content in the ocean water is also another important factor of ocean current. Then other than that, planetary winds, that means permanent winds are there. There is a wind system which is blowing over the planet, over the earth, continuously throughout the year from a particular place to a definite direction. They are called planetary winds. I'll be discussing about the planetary winds in detail with the help of a diagram in this video. Okay, so you will come to know which are the planetary winds and how these planetary winds are causing the origin of ocean currents. Then also, what is that Coriolis force and the rotation of the earth is also another important factor which causes the formation of ocean currents. Other than that, land feature, you see, wherever the land is there the ocean current take the diversion. Okay, so this also we will be discussing. So all these factors are the causes of the origin of the ocean current. So we all these things we will be discussing in this video. This will be an only introductory pack, but all these concepts we will be discussing in following videos. Ocean water has got mainly three type of movements. They are waves, tides and ocean currents. So we have already discussed in previous videos about waves and tides in details. Now in this video we are mainly going to discuss about the ocean current. So first of all, let us go through the definition of ocean current. So what is ocean current? The ocean current is the regular movement of ocean water from one part to another in a defined direction. How can it be a regular movement of ocean water? So let's see that it is a regular movement of ocean water. You can see here, you see you can see small stream here. So this is the ocean. Within the ocean itself, if you observe clearly, you can see the small streams. You see, these are the stream. This white patches you can see here, this can be considered as the streams. This can be also considered as just like stream, or otherwise these can be also considered as a small rivers like. Okay, so sometimes their length can be
1000 kilometers to, and then width can be maximum 200 kilometer. Okay, so this kind of number of streams can be observed on the surface of the ocean. Okay, so these streams, they never change their direction. They throughout the year from particular part to another part in a defined direction. Suppose this stream is flowing in this particular direction, so it will never change the directions. It move throughout the year in the same direction. So this kind of streams or rivers which are flowing in the ocean throughout the year from one part to another in a defined direction is called ocean currents. You can, this can be clear with the help of this video. You can see, if you observe here, you can see the stream here. You can see, okay, all these some white patches you can see. If you clearly observe, you can see the streams flowing in the ocean. Okay, this is another one. So in this you can very clearly understand that, so how the stream is flowing within the ocean. In the, within the ocean itself, there is a stream or river of water which flow from particular direction to another direction. So this kind of stream of ocean water can be called as ocean currents. So we learned about two type of ocean current. The ocean current which flow from the equator to the polar region. You see this red color is indicating the ocean current which flow from the equator region to polar region. Such kind of ocean current is called warm ocean current. Then the ocean current which flow from the polar region to the equatorial region are called cold ocean current. Okay, this can be clear with the help of a map. You can see here in this map, you can see the red arrows are indicating the warm ocean current, and the blue arrows are indicating the cold ocean current. So let us make this point more clear. Suppose this is the earth, the middle, the latitude which passes through the middle is equator, that is 0 degree. Okay, so 0 degree latitude divides the earth into northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. So the ocean current always which move from the equatorial region to polar region. So I'm marking it with red arrows here. So the ocean current which flow from the equatorial region to polar region are called warm ocean current. So from the, in the southern hemisphere, it move from the equatorial region to the south polar region. The northern hemisphere, it moved towards the north polar region. Now, the ocean current which flow from the polar region, that is in the north pole, it is moving towards the equatorial region. Again, in the south pole also, the ocean currents are moving towards the equatorial region. Understood? So, the ocean current which flow from the equatorial region to polar region are called warm ocean current. The ocean current which flow from the polar region to the equatorial region are called cold ocean current. Is it clear? Once again, I explain. The ocean current which flow from the equatorial region to the polar region are called warm ocean current. The ocean current which flow from the polar region to the equatorial region are called cold ocean current. So I hope this point is very clear. So we discussed what is ocean current, and now we also discussed about two type of ocean current. They are warm ocean current and cold ocean current. So warm ocean current, we learned that they flow from the equatorial region to the polar region. Let's see this. Suppose this is the shape of the earth, then equator divides the earth into two equal halves. So you see that in the definition, what it says, the textbook, it says that the ocean currents which flow from the higher latitudes, the higher latitudes means warmer areas in the tropical zone to the lower latitudes, that is in the cold areas in the temperate zone, can be called as warm ocean current. How it is higher latitude and lower latitude? What do you mean by high, lower latitude and high? You see that equator, then as one move from the equator to the polar region it is 90 degree here, okay. So equator it is 0 degree. So here you see this is Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree, and again Arctic Circle 66.5 degree, and finally North Pole it is 90 degree. So here you see as you move from the equator to the polar region, the latitude values are increasing. So the higher latitudes means polar region and lower latitude means equatorial region. Here in the southern hemisphere also same thing. Here you see Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 degree south, and Arctic Circle that is 66.5 degree south, then finally South Pole, that is South Pole, okay, that is 90 degree, clear. So as you move from the equatorial region to the polar region, you are moving from the lower latitude to the higher latitude. So the warm ocean current always flow from the lower latitude, that means from the equatorial region to the polar region. So equatorial regions are the warmer region and polar regions are the colder region. So equatorial region can be called as tropical zone. So the zone which lies between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer in the northern hemisphere, and the equator and the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere, can be, this much area can be called as tropical zone, clear, tropical zone. So the ocean, then this much portion can be the area between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle, and also the area between the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle can be called as what? Temperate zone. This is called temperate zone. Is it clear? Temperate, and also this is a subpolar region. This is subpolar region. Here also this is also north. This is north temperate zone, and this is south temperate zone, and this is north subpolar region. Clear. So the cold ocean current, they flow from the temperate zone or subpolar region and temperate zone to tropical zone. That means cold ocean current flow from the colder region, that means polar region, to the equatorial region. These are the cold ocean current. Cold ocean current, let me make it clear. Let me draw it with blue color so that it will be clear. So, cold ocean current flow from the polar region to the equatorial region. So, that is what you understood this. So, these currents, warm ocean currents flow from the lower latitude, that is warmer area in the tropical zone, to the latitudes of higher latitudes of colder areas in the temperate and the subpolar region. Clear? Then the ocean, cold ocean current is also clear. This currents flow from the latitudes, that means colder areas, towards the lower latitude, that is warmer area. These currents flow from the polar region. So always warm ocean current, they flow from the equatorial region, and cold ocean current, so warm ocean current always flow from the equatorial region, and cold ocean current always flow from the polar region. I hope this point is very clear. We discussed about ocean currents, and two type of ocean current, they are the warm ocean current and cold ocean current. Next, we have to discuss the causes of ocean current. What are the causes of ocean current? One of the most important cause of the ocean current is that planetary winds. So let's discuss what is this planetary wind. So in order to discuss the planetary wind, let us draw a diagram. So with the help of diagram, we can understand what are planetary winds. Suppose if you draw the diagram like this, the Earth, the equator divides the Earth into two equal half, that is 0 degree, 0 degree equator. Okay, then suppose this is 30 degree latitude, 30 degree latitude, then 60 degree latitude, then 90 degree latitude. Again, see, let me draw that latitude, and this is also can be considered 30 degree, and here it is 60 degree and 90 degree. So this is 90 degree south and this is 90 degree north. This is 60 degree north and 30 degree north. Here this is 30 degree south and 60 degree south. Clear? And in the middle 0 degree, that is equator. Clear? So there are some permanent which are flowing in this particular latitude. Which are those permanent winds? We have to identify those permanent winds. This is 0 degree. Okay. So the wind which blow from 30 degree latitudes to 0 degree, which blow from the 30 degree to 0 degree latitude in the northern hemisphere and also in the southern hemisphere. The southern hemisphere also the wind is blowing from the 30 degree to 0 degree latitude. This latitude, this wind can be named as northeast trade winds. These winds are called northeast trade winds. Okay. So the wind which blow in the northern hemisphere from the 30 degree latitude to 0 degree is called northeast trade wind. Then which blow from the 30 degree to 0 degree in the southern hemisphere is called what? Southeast trade wind. Is it clear? You keep in mind that the wind which blow from 30 to degree to 0 degree is called trade wind. If it is in the northern hemisphere, that trade wind is called northeast trade wind. If it is blowing from the southern hemisphere, then that wind can be called as southeast trade wind. Why east direction? Because you see, these wind, they origin there from eastern direction. This is the east and this is west. So this trade winds are always easterlies. Why? Because they are always blowing from the eastern direction. Now another set of wind is there always blowing. They are blowing always in the western direction. They are origin from this. So winds are always given their name from where, from the direction in which they origin. So the trade winds are always their origin is in from the eastern direction. That is why they are called easterly. That's why they are called northeast trade wind in the northern hemisphere and southeast trade wind in the southern hemisphere. The similar way, there are westerlies. You see, there are the wind system which blow from the 60 degree latitudes to 30 degree latitude. Their direction is 60 degree to 30 degree latitude. And they are called westerlies because their direction is west. They origin from the western direction. So they are called westerlies. So we can call them as northwesterly. Why northwesterly? Because in the northern hemisphere. Okay. Then again, the wind system which blow from the 60 degree to 30 degree latitude in the southern hemisphere is called southwesterlies. Is that clear? Okay. So keep in mind, the trade winds blow from the 30 degree to 0 degree and westerlies blow from the 60 degree to 30 degree. Clear? Then another set of wind which blow always from the 90 degree to 60 degree. Their direction is 90 degree to 60 degree in the northern hemisphere. and also in the southern hemisphere their direction is 90 degree to 60 degree. So they are called easterlies. Why? Because they always origin from the eastern direction. They are called easterlies. Another name of easterly is that polar wind. Easterlies or polar winds. So this is northeasterly and this is southeasterly. I hope this point is clear. Okay, once again I'll explain this without the diagram. You see that trade winds, always remember trade winds, their origin is trade winds. Trade winds always blow from 0 degree latitude, sorry, always blow from 30 degree latitudes to 30 degree latitudes to 0 degree latitude, and westerlies blow from 60 degree latitudes to 30 degree latitude, and easterlies means polar winds. No space here. Easterlies. Little difficult to write here. So easterly. Okay, let me rub it off and I'll write the third one. Is that easterlies? That is easterlies. Easterlies are our polar winds. Polar winds. So their direction is always 90 degree to 60 degree. Is it clear? Once again, with the help of the diagram, let me clear this. You need to by heart these permanent winds. You see this 0 degree. This is 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree. Northern hemisphere, North Pole. Let me draw once again. Yeah. 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degree. And this is also 0 degree, then 30 degree, 60 degree. And 90 degree. Okay, so the trade wind always blow from 30 degree to 0 degree. So this is called northeast trade wind, and this trade wind is called southeast trade wind. Then westerlies always blow from 60 degree to 30 degree. These are named as westerlies because they origin from the western direction. So this is northwesterly. And here in the southern hemisphere, if they blow from 60 to 30 degree, then they are called southwesterly. Then the next is that easterly. Easterly's direction is also eastern direction. So they always blow from the eastern direction. That is from the 90 degree to 60 degree they blow. So these are called planetary winds or permanent winds. They blow. Why? Because they call permanent winds. They continuously blow throughout the year in the same direction. Planetary winds or another name is that permanent winds. Clear? So which are the planetary winds and permanent winds? Trade winds, northeast trade wind and southeast trade wind, northwesterly and southwesterly, and northeasterly or north polar winds, and southeasterly or south polar winds. So these are the permanent winds which are flowing in our planet throughout the year towards a defined direction. So we learned about ocean current. What was the definition of ocean current? The regular movement of the ocean water from one part to another part throughout the year in a defined direction. So the similar way, the planetary winds, they are the wind which blow from one part to another throughout the year in a defined direction. Why defined direction? What is a trade winds? Always they they blow from 30 degree to 0 degree, and their direction is always from the east. They origin from the east and they blow westwards. Understood? So westerly is always, their direction is same. They origin from western direction and they move towards the eastern direction. They flow eastward the east. So like that, these permanent winds are flowing throughout the air from one part to another in a defined direction. So ocean current also is that same definition. So you can understand that the oceans are there. On the earth there are oceans. So these oceans are also flowing according to the direction of the planetary winds. Suppose you see the ocean currents also, suppose the northeast trade wind is always directing the ocean currents. Okay, so ocean currents are also origin according to the direction of the planetary winds. Understood? So this is what planetary winds, and planetary winds are causing the origin of ocean currents. So children, I am winding up this video here, and rest we will discuss in another video.